Blog Talk Radio.
Living my life in a slow hell. Different girl every night at the hotel. I ain't seen the sunshine in 3 damn days. Been fueling up on cocaine and whiskey. Wish I had a good girl to miss me. Lord, I wonder if I'll ever change my ways. I put your picture away, sat down and cried today. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to her. I put your picture away, sat down and cried today. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to her.
I called you last night in the hotel. Everyone knows.
lakes and pines, they bleed of beauty and grace. And the rivers, they run wild like an endless race. The forest soars so high, then fall to the sea. It'll be when it comes back around.
shattered windows and the sound of drums. People couldn't believe what I'd become.
Michael Long, and I apologize for coming in late here. A little bit of traffic problems headed to the back to the house here, but we're all set here for a great show, so thanks for joining me tonight. Psychic medium Barbara will be joining us here from the UK in just a few minutes. So give us a call, light up the phone lines, and if you're on the phone lines right now, I thank you for patiently waiting. We'll get your calls here in just a second. Thanks, everybody, for being here tonight, everybody in the Jill Family chat room. Just want to let you guys know, I'll skip the normal introductions, I'm running late. But don't forget about the New Year's Eve show coming up Friday night, when my guests will be Jenny Satori and Dionysus. We're going to do a lot more than just readings. We're going to look in the year past before we go into readings. We're going to look at some changes I'm going to be doing this new year coming up. A lot of things I think you're going to like. And your karaoke songs and the countdown from Times Square live here on Jill. So a lot of fun there. So let me quickly go to my switchboard and bring in my guest tonight, psychic medium Barbara. Barbara, are you there?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Yes, I am. Hello.
Oh, hello. Sorry for the delay there. Hopefully you enjoyed the music.
Yeah, I did. How are you?
Oh, okay. Okay. How is it going over there?
Excellent. Yes, ready for 2011.
You get enough. Last time we talked, you were like in the middle of a snowstorm, were you not? Do you get plenty of snow out there?
Yes, and it's almost gone now, so it's fun to be in the snow, but not for long, so it's good that it's melting right now.
Yeah. I imagine that. Luckily, I'm not in, I shouldn't say that, I love snow, but a lot of the parts of the U.S., especially the Northeast, and has been just inundated. I'm sure you've seen it on the news.
New York, everything. Oh, are there still planes flying to New York, or is everything down?
I don't know if they've started them back out yet or not, or if it's going to be another day, last I heard, but it's kind of crawling. Barbara, why don't you let everybody know kind of a little bit about yourself and how people can reach you?
Yes, well, I'm a psychic medium, and of course, I have my own website. If people want to find out more about me, who I am and what I do, they can take a look at my website. That's barbara-psychicmedium.com. And there you can find all the info.
Okay. And did you want to tell them about your own radio show that you do?
I have a radio show, 60 Psychic Minutes, on Voice America every Thursday on it's 10 a.m. Eastern time, and until February, and then it's a lot of fun. I'm the host, and trying to get good guests every week. Yeah, and I like to do radio much more than doing television.
Oh, you do.
I'm too shy to do television.
Oh.
I am. So I'd rather be on the radio.
Yeah. Well, it's more comforting, I guess.
Yes.
So let's go to the phone lines then and see who we have for you. And we invite everybody to call in. 347-884-8245 is the number to call in. And let's first go to area code 516. You're on the air. We get your first name and where you're calling from.
Hi, Mike. My name is Frank. I'm calling from New York. And hi, Barbara.
Hey, Frank.
Well, I want to say Happy New Year to everybody, just in case I don't get to call you again.
Yeah.
My question is, I'd like to know if you have any messages for me from my guides.
Okay. Is it bad over there? Are you, like, in your house for the last couple of days, or can you go outside?
Well, it's pretty snowy out still. You know, it's some of it's clean and stuff, but I sort of, like, hibernated.
Okay, good. Okay, well, in the meantime, I could focus on your guides. And your mother... when she was very little, her own mother couldn't raise her for a short period when she was small. Do you know anything about that period of your mother's life?
Yes.
Because for a short period, she was raised by somebody else, and that woman I feel around you. It feels like a grandmother, but she's not. So I think she's family, but not your grandmother. Maybe it's the sister of your grandmother, but she took care of your mother when she was little. Can you...
Yes, I know who that is.
You know? Oh, thank God. Okay, good. Because I also feel that her husband, I also feel him around her. And I don't know why, but they... they didn't divorce, but they had to split up for a period of time in their life. Do you know that?
The people that raised my mom or my grandparents?
No, the people that raised your mother.
Something
happened in their life, and they had to be apart for, a couple of months or years.
I don't know about that part.
Okay, could you ask your mother if she is still around you, if she knows about this, or somebody else? Because I feel these people are around you, and they are so loving towards you. Their energy is very gentle and almost shy. And they are helping you to be less shy.
Okay.
That's what I'm feeling.
I can't ask my mom because she's on the other side.
Okay, good, because I don't feel your mother around you, so that's why I ask. Maybe you can ask your mom, but can you ask somebody else who knows about this period of time in your mother's life?
Everyone in my mom's family is in Argentina, and I'm not. Most of them are on the other side.
Okay, good. Well, not good, but I mean that it's because the reason they are showing me that they were apart for a while is that they are very happy to be together again now in the spirit world, and they are practically all the time together. I don't see that a lot, that people who were married, they join when they're both in the spirit world, they join. But they also just do their own things. But these t- two lovely people. They are like hand in hand. Everywhere they go together. And you have got it's a small closet in your living room, and it's an old closet. Is this in your living room or another room in your apartment?
I have a closet in my bedroom and a closet in the, yeah, the front door.
It's like small. Do you call it a cabinet? Is that the right word? Like a small closet you can put things and picture on it, pictures or candles or something like that?
I have a jelly cabinet near the front door.
Okay, but this is an old, they're showing me a really old one, and it belongs in the family. Do you have this?
A closet?
No, it's smaller than a closet. It's like half the size of a closet.
Me personally or my brother?
It's in your family, and they're showing me it in a living room. So I don't know if it's your living room or your brother's living room, but it's in the family. And it belonged to your mother, your grandmother.
Hmm. Well, I don't have any family in the U.S., just me and my brother.
Mm-hmm. Because this piece of furniture belongs to them. So maybe you can think about where it is, because that piece of furniture was very special to them. I think if you can find out where it is, I think they want you to have it. And sometimes when I say things, you know, people a few days later, they go like, oh, right, that's what she meant. You know, sometimes you have to think about it a couple of days.
Are you able to find out if I have it or my brother has it?
Yes. You or your brother, but it belongs to you. They want you to have it.
Is there any reason why they want me to have that?
Yes, because of the energy that's around this furniture. This their energy is still all. You know what I mean? When people die, they leave their energy on things, and it belongs to you. That's what I'm hearing all the time. It belongs to you. They want you to have it, and it's very, very old. It's antique.
An antique piece of furniture in my family. The only other person would be me or my brother. And he doesn't own anything like that.
Okay, well, maybe it's somewhere where you keep things, or your brother, you know, or storage or whatever, but it's there. It's somewhere, and it belongs to you. Can I go back to the woman who raised your mother?
Yes, please.
Okay, because her husband isn't very talkative, but she is. And she wants you to know, first of all, that they are around you, but also that she's going to help you to push forward in 2011. She's going to give you courage, and she's going to make sure that everything you want that you can start with in 2011. It's like she's pushing you over obstacles that you still have, and she's trying to help you with this, and she's doing a great job.
Oh, great.
Yes, if you ever want something, you can ask her.
Does she have a name?
You know, I rarely get names. I usually get initials. And so I'm seeing the letter M of Maria. And she's also talking about your shyness. She's going to help you with that, to overcome your to become less shy and do your own thing, because the path you are on now is going to change. You're going in another way, in another direction. And that feels so good, and she's helping you with this. And I think you know what I'm talking about. It's something you want for years, but you have to find a way to do it.
Okay.
Do you have any other questions?
Oh, Well, when I call out to my guides, is she the one who's answering these? Because I call out
no,
to my
they,
guides.
Yeah.
Are they my guides, or are they, like, just near me?
We all have a number of guides, and she is the one that I can make contact with. So if you talk to your guides, you can address them all. And she's one of your guides.
Okay.
So if you want to ask something, just say, dear guides, then you get the whole group in one.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Yeah, good.
Okay, that's pretty much it. I don't want to take up too much time. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Right. Okay,
take
bye.
Care,
thank you, Mike.
Happy New
and
Year.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Right. Take care.
Bye.
Okay. Good friend there, Frank. You got him a lot of help there. Let's go next to area code 970. You're on with Psychic Medium Barbara. Can we get your first name and where you're calling from?
Hi, Barbara and Mike. This is Lisa in Colorado.
Welcome, Lisa.
Hi. Hi.
Hi.
I wanted to ask you, I have a job interview tomorrow, and I just want to know if you can give me any advice from my guides about maybe what to say or what not to say in order to do the best I can.
Oh, I like that question. Okay, let me see. Yeah, when you enter a room, you always give a very good first impression because you have a very open face. Open as in people like you at first sight. Do you know what I mean? So when you enter a room, when you enter a room, it's like, hey, that's Lisa. Okay, she feels good. So that's 0-1 for you, and then what you can say or what kind of attitude you need to, let's see. You have a tendency to be, okay, let me put it this way, you don't sell yourself. You should sell yourself more. Just say what you, because you can do a lot. You have, you're perfect for this job, and you have to sell yourself, and that's a point to work at. So go in there, be your smashing self, and take over the place. Yes.
Okay, I was going to ask you, I had asked my guides a couple of weeks ago or so for help in directing me to, I don't know how to say it, I guess, well, I asked if they could help me find my soul family here on Earth, you know, just because I have a hard time finding people that I can relate to and I get along with and I, you know,
yeah,
want that closeness with people. And I just wondered if this, you know, maybe getting this job has anything to do with that, because it happened so suddenly where the opportunity came along, you know, just a couple of days ago. And I hadn't even thought about working before that time.
I think that's such a beautiful question you asked. And they will let you meet your soul family. And I think that because you're so young, and you're gonna be here for a long, long time. So you will meet in the coming years. Every now and then, you will meet a member of your soul family. And the first one, I'm seeing a woman, and she will be the first one you will meet as a soul mate, a soul sister. So yes, they are working on this for you.
Okay.
And I don't think you have any idea how what you do to people when you enter a room. I don't think you have a clue, and I mean this in a positive way, but when you enter a room, there's really somebody entering. Don't you notice that when you enter a room? Or are you?
No, I'm really shy, so I try to look away.
Yeah, I see you staring at your shoes. Okay, could you, when you go in tomorrow, just your head high in the sky and be firm? Are you still there?
Yes. Okay.
Okay. I heard a strange noise. So, I want you to be aware of your energy and the way you come across to people, because it's very powerful in a good way.
Okay. I didn't realize that.
No. And I'm glad I can say this to you, because I think it will change your whole attitude. And when you change your own energy towards people, people will change the way they look at you in a positive way. So just go in there and say, I want this job. Well, not literally, but
right.
To yourself.
But
yourself.
I guess confidence.
Yes, because you have every right to be confident, really. You have. You're
okay.
Perfect for this job.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much. That helps.
Okay, well, good luck tomorrow.
Thank you. You guys have a happy new year.
Happy new year.
Bye. Bye.
Happy new year. Okay, good night. Okay, let's next go to Pennsylvania, area code 814. You're on the air. Could we get your first name, please? Area code 814, are you there? Last call for area code 814. Okay, I guess your line went dead. Please call back and we'll get you your call then. Let's see. Okay, let's try. Line keeps blinking. Area code 410, are you there? Hello, area code 410. Okay, looks like I'm going to update my switchboard here. Try one more. Area code 559, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can we get your first name and where you're calling from?
My name is Evelyn, and I'm calling from California.
Evelyn, is that right?
Evelyn.
Evelyn, okay, welcome to the show. Go ahead.
I want to know if you could tell me what 2011 holds for me in terms of relationship and finances.
Okay, hi, Evelyn. Your line isn't that good, so you want to know about finances and romance in 2011?
Correct.
Okay, good. Finances will be, you're going to try to make your finances better and you will succeed. I see an increase of finances in the latter part of 2011. So you don't have to worry about that, because you're going to do your best to make more money. So that's very positive. And romance is a different story. I think, oh, you're laughing. I think you have to make a choice, a very important choice. And what I'm here.
Yes. Ada?
Okay, Barbara, are you there?
I think we lost her.
Okay, Barbara, we did lose her. Switchboard. Okay, caller, if you can hang on just a minute here, put you back on hold. Obviously, I have a problem with the switchboard. And I see Alan, area code 410. Come to you next after this caller. So if you get bumped off, just call back and you can let me know in the chat. Also, you can get next to speak to our guest by just contributing to the show at journeyintothelight.org, journeyintothelight.org. And then just let me know in the chat room. We'll get you up next. Okay, switchboard is reloading here, and I don't see my guest, so she'll be here shortly. Just to let you know, if you're new to the show, click on the little heart icon. This way you'll get an update 1 hour before my show starts, letting you know who the guests are. A lot of times we have, our shows are normally Sunday through Thursday starting at 8 p.m. Eastern time, but sometimes we have different times we start the show. We have daytime shows, we have weekend shows. So check that out. Click the little heart icon. It's a great tool to use. Let's see here. Barbara, are you there?
I'm sorry. We got disconnected. I'm sorry.
Yeah, we drifted away.
Yeah.
Oh, well, sorry about that.
No.
Okay, we got you back now, and let's reconnect you with Evelyn, okay. You're back on the air.
Oh, good. You're still there.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, good. Okay. Because I told you that your guides want you to put yourself first instead of somebody else. And I see two different men around you. So I think there's a big and very important choice coming in 2011.
Okay.
And, you know, I'm follow your heart. That's all I can say about that. Because I think, at least I feel, that you already know what your heart wants you to do.
My heart is very confused at the moment.
Yes. And it's always difficult when your heart is confused to be very honest to yourself. To peel away the layers of why your heart is confused. Is it because you are afraid of being alone, or is it afraid that you might get hurt, or is the other person not good for you but you don't want to admit it? So it's tough to be very honest to yourself, but I'm sure you can do it. And when you peel off those layers of your heart, you find out what the truth is for yourself, and you will feel so relieved.
Well,
can I help? Sorry?
No, I'm very impressed. You basically told me what I'm going through, and I'm impressed.
But can I help you with this? Can I mean?
I don't know if I'm thinking if it's between two of my exes. One of them is Alex, and the other one is Jose. Back and forth with the idea of them. So I'm thinking that this is probably the choice I have to make between both of these men.
Okay, would it help you if I told you a little bit about what these men want from you? Would that help you, or would it confuse you more, because I don't want to be more confusing for you.
It would help me a lot.
Okay, because one of them, and I don't know if it's, you said Alex and Jose, am I right?
Yes.
Okay, one of them, and I don't know if that's Alex or Jose, but one of them is manipulative towards you, and this person doesn't want you to grow. He wants you to be who you are, and he isn't allowing you to grow spiritually and as a human being. And the other person is emotionally not so strong as you are. So you are more mature emotionally. And actually, he is very comfort. He finds comfort in a woman who nurtures him. Do you recognize this in...
Yes,
because I do.
Manipulator, yes, and the emotional one, yes, I know who they are. And it's
okay.
You got it.
Okay, so, well, I would like to say bring in man number three, because I would love for you to meet somebody who is equal to you, who has the same energy. And I think a good relationship is a relationship where two people can grow and they don't block each other and there are no manipulations, or, you know, that it's equal and it's... and I don't sense that with Alex or Jose. So if you be honest to yourself, like I said before, what it is that you can make a decision, that you're not going to be alone, or you name it, I think then you can find the answer in your heart.
I think the answer is neither of this men, like you said. I need a new man in my life that has the same goals as I do, and I do have a strong personality.
Yes. And that's good, and you also need somebody who's just as strong, but in a loving way. And you also have a very powerful sexual side with lots of passion. And that's also a very part of your being, of your who you are, and you need that in your life. So I think if you have the courage to be alone for a while and wait for man number three, it would turn out very good for you. But that's, of course, a decision you have to make yourself.
Great. I do. Thank you. Thank you very much. Do you see, hopefully, in the new future, the third man, the one that's more compatible for me?
Absolutely. I didn't want to say it myself because... You know, I want you to make a decision, but yes, there will be a man, because when you say to yourself, okay, I don't want this anymore, I don't want Alex, I don't want Jose, I want somebody who is right for me and who is, you know, like a soulmate, and I can grow in this relationship, then your wish will come true, absolutely. And... are you planning to start your own business?
No, I'm not. I'm planning to write. Sure, I would love to write books.
Okay, the line went bad for a few seconds. You want to write a book?
Yes, I do. But in terms of a business, no.
Okay, well, because the reason I asked is because I have a strong feeling that you will meet this third man when you're busy with your own thing, like writing a book, because it felt like your own company, but writing a book is also something you do on your own. So you will meet him, so start writing now. No, just kidding. But... he's on your life path, and you will meet him. I can't tell you when. Yes, I can't tell you when, but he's coming. He's heading your way. Hello?
Well, it's like
hello?
We dropped. Are you still there? No?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, I got you, Barbara. It's like she dropped off. One of these nights.
Yeah.
The snow in New York City. Could be. That's where the network is. Well, we'll just go on. Let's go to area code 410. This is, I believe, Alan. Alan, are you there?
This is Ayana.
Ayana. Okay, hang on. You'll be up soon. Here, I got the wrong one. Area code 410. Alan, are you there?
Yes.
Okay, you're on the air with Barbara.
Hi, Barbara.
Hi, Alan.
I just want to know if there was any... I sent you a private message, Mike, but you got to me anyway. I just want to see if there was any messages from the other side, maybe.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. You have to help me on this one. Okay. I don't think it's you, but somebody around you, like a good friend, lost a child. It's a young child, and it's like, it feels like no older than 3 or 4 years. Who is this? Is this a friend of yours who lost their young child?
Not that I know. Huh.
Because, okay, I'm sorry, I was distracted by your noise on the background. The minute you started to talk, I sensed this young child, and she wants you to tell her father that she's okay and happy. Okay, I want to get details so that you know who this is. This could be a child who crossed over many years ago. So I want you to go back in your memory and think about everyone you know. And she's pointing out to her dad, not to her mother, but to her dad. So her dad is still living, and she wants him to know that she is very happy. She had a problem with her lungs. So she died of a lung disease. And maybe she got water in her lungs or something like that, but she's showing me her lungs. So if you can think about everyone you know in your past around you who lost a child. And I said she, didn't I?
Yeah, she said she.
Yeah, because I couldn't see if it was a boy or girl, but I said she, so it's a girl. So she has a very strong energy because she was, bam, she was right there. So, okay, she won't let go. She wants you to tell her dad that she's okay. And this man is around you. He's in your family, in your friends, in relatives. I really hope you can find out who this is.
Yes, so do I.
Okay, so remember, it could be many years ago. It doesn't have to be in the... I want to see if I can make contact with somebody else. Are your finances okay, Alan?
Yes, so far.
Okay.
I mean, I'm not rich, but I make my bills.
Okay, good. You know, sometimes when somebody passed over, some people have a very, very strong energy. And I'm trying to feel other people around you who passed over. But she is still there, the young child. I really hope you can find out who her dad is, because she won't let
go. Does he have any names or anything that, or any help?
I already tried. I already tried to I'm talking to her, you know, in my mind, and she's very excited, but a little bit too, because she's a little bit too excited because I can't pass her energy to feel other energies who belong to you. And that
but
sometimes
can she tell me her parents' name or her first name to help me?
No, but her dad has financial problems, or had financial problems. That's why I asked you if your finances were okay. But it's about her dad.
Uh-huh.
Okay, your dad knows, was friends with this man, with her dad. So it goes back to your dad. Is your father still alive?
Yes.
Could you ask him, or is he scared of these things?
No, I could ask him.
Okay, because yes, he is a friend of your father. So your father's friend lost his daughter.
Okay.
And I think this is, so she won't leave me alone. So I hope that I can comfort her and tell her that you are going to find out who her dad is, so you can give the message that she is very happy now. I think that he is still very much in pain over her death, and she wants him to let him know that that she's okay. Okay, do you have another question for me? Because I want to feel for you who is around you, but she's there, so I can't go.
Well, that's okay. I really don't have any more questions. I'll go ahead and let somebody else have a chance.
Okay. Well, could you let me know in some way, or maybe you can email Mike if you find out who her father is, because I'm very curious.
Yes, sure. I'll surely do that. Thank you so
okay.
much.
Okay. Okay, bye, Ellen.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye, Michael.
Bye.
Take care, Ellen. Bye.
Wow.
Okay, we'll get some confirmation on that a little bit later.
Yeah.
Let's go to Texas and bring in Mellow Yellow from the chat room. Stephanie, you're on there.
Hi, Michael. Hi, Barbara. How are y'all doing?
Hi.
Great.
Thank you so much for taking my call. Well, Barbara, I have had a string of losses over the last few years, and I just wanted to see if you can pick up anything from any of my loved ones on the other side. You know, with the holidays and all, it's...
Yes, I understand. Oh, did you hear the last conversation?
I didn't hear the very last part. I was
okay, because... oh, okay.
Sorry.
That's okay. But I was talking to Alan, and I felt this little girl around me, talking to him. And she's still here, so I'm having kind of a hard time to putting her energy aside because she's so strong.
Okay.
Did you went to the hospital for a kind of a checkup, like a small thing? It wasn't serious, but it was a small thing.
I've just recently been at the hospital, but it was for someone that I lost. Maybe that's what you're picking up on the hospital. I'm not sure. This is about me?
Yes, because I'm getting the message for you that it's okay. That's what they want to tell you. It's okay. And I'm picking up an older lady around you, and she is very strong. She has been there so many times when she passed over to also visit relatives and friends. So she went every time you had to go, she went with you. And she wants you to let you know that you are okay. So maybe you had worries or something like that, but you're okay. That's the main message. And I'm also picking up on a younger man who passed over. Okay, I see a younger man. I think he is, I'm not so good with ages, but I think he is around 30, 35, maybe 40, but not older than that. And he has dark hair. And he feels part of your family too. And he passed over. I can't feel how long he's already in the spirit world. Okay, he's talking about your hands, the power in your hands. Are you already working with that?
No.
Okay. Are you aware that you have that power in your hands?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I do have a male, but about 40s, in the 40s. It was passed over. I'm not sure if that's who you're picking up on.
Yeah, because he has a very gentle energy, and he doesn't want to rush you into things, but your guides are going to help you with your spiritual development, because you are very spiritual, and he's in charge of your hands. It sounds weird, but that's what they're showing me.
Okay.
So I hope you will be more aware of this, because you have one hand is more developed than your other hand, and you can magnetize. I don't know if you know what that is. You know, to give energy with your hands to people who are in pain.
Right.
That's what you are capable of.
I know about people that do energy healing. I don't use, I see somebody in chat, I don't use Reiki, how do you say it?
Reiki,
that's it.
Yeah.
But, I do have some friends that do that.
But Stephanie,
I haven't thought about it.
I see you holding people's hands. You already done that. When you hold somebody's hand who is sick, they are, you know, that you calm them. You have a calm energy, so you already are magnetizing without even knowing.
Okay. Yeah, I am very touchy-feely.
You are.
I'm
you
rubbing
are,
my puppy right now. I love to. Yeah, I'm very touchy. I love to.
You're giving him a free Reiki treatment
yeah.
right now. Oh, but your hands are so powerful, and you're not aware of it, so... I hope that you are now.
Okay, I'll think about that, because, yeah, definitely, that, you know, touch is healing, that's for sure, whether you use Reiki or not, I guess.
Yeah, well, it comes naturally to you. You don't have to follow a class or whatever. You do it naturally, your natural talent. And the man I feel around you with the young man with dark hair, he is showing me his teeth, and he has such a beautiful, like, real white teeth. He's so proud of his mouth and his lips and his teeth.
Okay.
And he's constantly giving me a very big smile.
Okay. Yeah, that is funny, because somebody was just commenting on a picture of me, how everyone in our family has big white teeth. Oh, I do have
without
a brother.
Treatment.
With that, yeah, I never really thought about it. It was kind of funny that they mentioned that, because you know how you don't notice things about yourself.
No.
But he made a comment that, yeah, everybody, I always think of you guys with your big teeth.
Not really. As white as snow, pearls, yes. So, they're gently pushing you in the direction of giving people treatments.
Okay.
Gently,
well,
gently, very gently.
Okay. I'll think about that, yeah. I'm so used to going, I've recently lost my stepdad. I'm so used to going to the nursing home to visit the old people. That sounds bad, but, you know, the people in the nursing home that I'm going to have to go up there and see them all because I'm, so, you know, I bring my pets. And so, yeah, it's just therapeutic for all of us. So, you know, I lost my stepdad and it's just been,
and
I've just had one loss after another in my family, but I'm doing okay. It's just kind of like, I don't know why that seems to happen. Things, you know, kind of come and
yeah. And it's also strange that it's also usually three in a row. I don't know why that is, but it's usually three
I've
in a row.
Five.
Sorry?
Yeah. I've had five losses. Close.
Wow.
To, you know, close.
Yeah. Oh.
Kind of, yeah. It's amazing. And before that, well, I've had a couple, but you know, five close losses. I'm
a
survivor. Yeah. I'm surviving, but yeah, by the grace of God. But, well, thank you so much, Barbara, and thank you, Michael. And y'all have a good evening and a happy New Year.
Yes, you have a happy New Year too. Thank you.
Thank
you. Happy New Year to you, Stephanie. God bless.
Thanks, Mike. You too.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
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 She's been through a lot, you know, that many losses in such short time.
Yeah. Oh. And she feels so strong.
Yeah. Ellen, you know, the previous caller, wanted me to ask you, did the girl give you a name?
No. No, she didn't. She was jumping up and down, and she didn't give me a name. I'm so hoping that he can find out who her dad is.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have news of that here soon. You know, it's when you do a reading, you know, it's amazing how at that time sometimes it won't make sense or you'll be able to connect it. But later on,
yeah,
all of a sudden, you know, something will happen to you. You know, you remember it or something will come up. And
yeah, that happens a lot.
Okay. Let's see. We got to go next to. Let's go to Paula in the chat room. Area code 864. You're on the air. Welcome.
Thank you very much for taking my call.
Sure.
My name is Paula, and I'm calling from South Carolina.
Hi.
Hi, hon. How are you tonight?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing great. Just wanting to see if maybe there's messages from the other side and what it looks like for me being able to get a specific house that I've been hoping to buy for a long time. It's called the Old Gray Farm.
The Old Gray Farm, what a nice name. Okay, and you want to buy this house and you want to know if this will happen.
Right.
Okay, I do have the feeling that you're going to buy this. Do you have, like, a lot of plans to rebuild it?
Not to rebuild it. It's already been restored, but actually I would like to take it back to the original layout of the house.
Yeah, yeah. Good, because that's what they want. And I mean, with they, I mean the guides. So, yes, they love your plans. And, okay, one wall, and maybe you know this already, but one wall is not good. There's something wrong with the wall. Maybe it's got, have you had it checked already, like somebody who can see if everything's okay, and have you already done that?
No, it literally just came up for sale again in the last couple of months, and it was the home of the love of my life that passed away 3 years ago, and before I could get reconnected with him, he had passed away, but he had always wanted us to get married and to buy, it was his grandmother's home, and it's where he lived when I met him, and he had always wanted to inherit the home, which was supposed to happen, but it didn't, and farm the land with Christmas trees and flowers and pumpkins, and that's really what I'd like to do with it.
Wow. That's beautiful. Okay, because there's something wrong with one wall, and I think you can do something with the price, because you have to fix one wall.
Okay. So, and you know, that might be the wall that was torn down, and maybe Andy wants that wall back up because it would put his original bedroom back where it was.
Oh, okay. That could be. so I think the structure, there's something wrong with the structure, or so you'll see it if you like somebody who can check the house if everything's okay, he will see it. He or she will see
okay.
it, so you will find out. And it won't go smooth. You won't get it smoothly, so you have to do your best to get it, but you will succeed.
Okay.
So don't
then
give up.
Are there any... I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I wanted to say if you have... you know, if something goes wrong, don't think, oh, my God, I won't get it, because you have to be very firm and just hold on.
Okay. And are there any messages from Andy?
Okay, his name is Andy.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, I'm getting a picture of a large bed of flowers, and he's saying that he gave this bed of flowers a name, and it has something to do with you. That's what he's showing me. It's a long bed of flowers, and the flowers have all kinds of colors. It's not one particular flower. It's all kinds of flowers, and yeah, your name is attached to the flowers. Does this ring a bell to you?
Only thing I can think of is, like I said, what I had wanted to do on the farm was plant a large flower garden to sell the cut flowers.
Well, I don't know if there are Paula flowers, but there is, the connection is that it's your name is attached to the flowers, and I don't know in what way, but that's what he's showing me. So
okay.
Sometimes when I'm getting images or a movie in my head, I don't know if it already happened or if it has to happen in the future. But that's a very clear message he gave me. And he is always sitting on the end of your bed. When you are sleeping, he's sitting on the end of your bed.
I feel him sit down on the bed a lot as I'm falling asleep.
Yeah. Well, that's Andy. Wow. Because he feels very responsible. And when you are sleeping, he can contact you. He can talk to you. And so he waits for you. He waits for you fall asleep, and then he can make jokes. You like to laugh together, you know, a lot. And
yes.
Yes. So That's
very much so. We were a comic team together.
Yes.
I mean, not professionally. I mean, just, you know, when we were together, we laughed all the time.
And you really are the love of his life. You really are. I don't want to sound like Hollywood, but the feeling I'm getting between the two of you is really a very, very deep soul connection. And he wants you to know that he is trying to show you where he lives. When you fall asleep, you travel with him. And he wants to show you where he is, and so that you have comfort that he's okay.
That makes tremendous sense. I guess because it was such a unusual passing, and I was trying to get back in touch with him and him me right before he passed, and then I had contacted him 7 weeks after he passed away, only I didn't know it. And it was very traumatic coming across his obituary at midnight and sitting alone. And it's been very difficult for me at times to make contact with him, I think because of just the sadness and the regret and the unfulfillment of reconnecting with him before he passed. So it's been a difficult journey to try, and I'm a psychic medium myself, but it's just been really hard for me to connect with him. And I have asked him, in fact, I asked him like 3 nights ago, I said, Andy, would you please show me how to do this? I'm trying.
Okay, well, he is showing you. Can I ask you something else?
Oh, you can ask me anything. I'm an open book here.
Yeah, that's wonderful. I see an old lady. She passed over, and she has the uniform of the Red Cross.
Oh, dear God. That would be my grandmother. She was very big on the Red Cross, and this, and even though this isn't the Red Cross, they work a lot with the Red Cross. This past Christmas season, I rang the bell for the Salvation Army in honor of my dad and my mom's mom and my sister who passed away.
Wow. Do you know what happens when you travel with Andy? This may sound very weird. I'm seeing this as a movie in my head. Andy is picking you up. He is on your bed. You fall asleep. You travel with him, and your grandmother is waiting and giving the okay for you to go with Andy to travel at night.
That makes a lot of sense. That makes, especially the dream I had a few nights ago where they showed me where everything. I had a dream, and I don't want to take up any more time, but I had a dream where I had gone to the other side, and my mom, my grandmother, Andy, everybody was there, and the house crumbled that I was in, mm-hmm. and they were telling me, you're free to go, you're free to go.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I understand. She waits till you get back with Andy. She's like some sort of border between two worlds.
Yes, that makes a lot of sense to me.
Okay.
A lot of sense.
So I'm so glad that Andy is so much around you and loving you so deeply.
Oh, it's very comforting. I know a lot of people think I'm half crazy because I tell everybody, I have the man I want. I don't need a man here in the physical sense. I have who I want because I know he's with me.
Yes. Well, let them think you're crazy. We know what the truth is, don't we?
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
Yes.
Well, I just, what a blessing you have been in my life today. I truly needed this. And, you know, today is my grandmother's birthday. So.
Oh, happy birthday to your grandmother.
So it makes a, it means a lot to me that she showed you things today. It really does.
Yes. Well, I'm very grateful I can make you a little bit happier.
Thank you so very much. And I wish everyone a blessed new year, and may the spirit shine on all of you for what you do.
Yes. Happy new year.
Thank you so much. And,
okay,
Michael, thank you for your show. You do wonderful good in this world with what you do.
Well, thank you very much. It means a lot to me. So you have a happy New Year's, and God bless.
Thank you guys so much.
Thanks for listening, calling in. All right, take care.
Bye.
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 Okay, wow, a lot of calls here tonight, real deep, deep calls too, really. Barbara, why don't you give out your contact information, and we'll take a slight break here so you can grab a glass of water or something.
Yes, my website is Barbara with all A's Barbara-psychicmedium.com. That's my website.
Okay. All righty, we'll take a break here, Barbara. I'll come right back to you.
Okay.
Okay, great. And then we'll come back here with the caller. We still have the rest of the hour remaining. Couple of things, y'all. I was going to say y'all, Jenny. Couple of things real quickly. One is, if you're trying to private message me and I'm not answering or slow, I'm just inundated by private messages tonight. People wanting to get on or seeing what place they're in. And that's one of the areas I'm going to be talking about New Year's Eve, because I'm getting to a place where we're trying to help as many people as we can, and you know how many hours Journey of the Light is on, the longest spiritual show on Blog Talk, as far as number of hours, number of listeners, but I get these private messages almost demanding to get on the air, and I can only go in order received unless you contribute to the show, and then my thank you to you is putting you up next. That's the only way I can get you on next, okay? Otherwise, it's not fair to everybody else to throw you in front of everybody else that has been waiting longer than you. And I'm going to address this. I think I got an answer for this. But I don't want to go into another year, 2011, after shows, feeling bad. And that happened a couple of nights ago. I won't say who, but someone basically just cussed me out because I didn't take their call, even though they had about 15 people in front of them. And that's just not right. I put in more hours than any spiritual show on the show. I'm not bragging or anything like that, but we provide a lot of hours for free readings. And so please be here New Year's Eve. I want to address that subject. Anyway, if you'd like to get on with Barbara, here, because we only got 30 minutes remaining, you can go to my website, journeyintothelight.org, journeyintothelight.org. Let me know in the chat room and send me a private message, and I'll get you up next, okay? This show only stays on the air with your help and our sponsors. That's it. This is my full-time job. I got to have help to continue the show. So by you contributing, you also get on the call next, but you're also helping the show. You're helping the show be here every night for people. So, and then the second thing I wanted to ask for some prayers here tonight. I got a request from in New York, Natalie, that comes to the show. She was wanting prayers. She said God would know what her intentions were. That was very important to do them tonight. So let's pray for Natalie in New York and also Natalie in Hawaii, things that she's going through with her health. And then Judy, let's pray for her and her family as Judy just lost her uncle. And then Lynn Butterfly, her mom just had surgery today. And let's pray for her continued health and the family. So I'm going to take a break here. And hopefully during the break we all can pray over those intentions and come back here with the rest of the callers.
keep singing, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with His glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with His glory.
To Journey into the Light. I think that'll be our new theme song here on Jill. Just love that song. Thanks everybody for participating and singing along in the chat room. Can hear your voices from all your different locations. So let's get back to the phone lines here and let's bring back our special guest tonight. Live from the UK, this is Barbara. Barbara, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay, welcome back.
Yes, thank you.
Let's see who we have for you next here. Let's go to a call that keeps dropping his line there. Area code 870, you're on the air. Can we get your first name? Are you there, area code 870? Let's go back here, and let's go bring up area code 917. You're on the air. Can we get your first name and where you're calling from?
I'm giving you a heads up. Oh, so you know that's fine.
Area code 917?
I don't think you want me to please. So
okay. They're not too eager to get to the phone. Let's try someone who's wanting to get on the air with Barbara. Area code 404. Are you on the air? Are you there? Okay, everybody, if you're actually calling in, can you stay by your phone, please? Okay, let's try area code 317.
Hello. Hi, my name is Michelle. How are you guys doing tonight?
Hey,
hi, Michelle.
Hi, Mike. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing great. Thanks for calling in.
Thank you. I've been listening to your show a lot. You've got a lot of fabulous guests on. Nice to meet you, Barbara.
Hi. Nice to meet you, too.
I love your energy. I have a question for you. 2011 going to be any better for me? Laugh out loud joke. I've been going through a lot of struggles this year, last year, and I'm just hoping that 2011 will be a brand new start for me as far as my love life and everything else is concerned.
It's going to be better. 2011 will be better. And mainly because you set goals for yourself and you're fed up with the way things were and you did it with your heart. So, yes. That's why 2011 will be better for you. Are you planning to move?
I want to get out of here. I'm going to be 30. I was living on my own and everything else, and I was in a major car accident last year. I lost everything. I had everything going for me. I had my own place to live, my job and everything else. And I got now. Car collision, had a major concussion. It was really strange how God works in mysterious ways. But the day after I was in a car accident, I lost my place to live, and my dad also lost his job, so I had to move in with my parents. So they needed me as much as I needed them, I guess. But it was really strange. 2009 was a very tragic year for me. 2010 wasn't that much better. And I just recently reconnected with my ex-fiancé, too, Michael, and I was wondering what you see with that one, because is the love of my life, and I'm kind of worried about his well-being sense. And I don't know if you've heard of spiritual connection, but
between people.
Yes,
you mean
I feel we've had a spiritual connection because I've been dreaming about him, and I feel some crazy things. And I just contacted him. He called me the end of November, beginning of December, and I did not like the way his tone of voice came on the phone. And I'm a very strong connection with God. And God came to me in a dream and told me that I need to get in contact with this man or he's going to die.
Oh, that's heavy news. Okay.
That's very heavy news, and it was very vivid.
Okay, and his name is Michael.
His name is Michael. His birthday is March 6th, 1980.
Okay, because first, I see you moving, and this feels very close by, so that's number one. Okay, you're regathering your strength. And what I'm hearing is that you need your strength to help Michael. He made a couple of wrong decisions, and some of them wasn't his own fault. Some of them were, but you're going to help him, and he will get back on his feet because of you.
He got himself entangled in a bad, bad situation, very deadly. It has to do with the child, and that's the sad part about it. It's a web of deception and denial and betrayal. And the woman claims for the kid to be his. The child's not even his. But the fact is he's stuck in it. I seen a recent picture of him on the internet, which, you know, how God works in mysterious ways and everything happens. Well, the dreams that I were having were so vivid that I asked spirit guides, because I'm psychic myself, to show me what I needed to see. And the picture that I remember him about, it's not look like the same Michael I remember. He looks terrible, major sags under his eyes, teeth missing. He's not a pretty boy no more, let's put it that way. And I just want to know what happened, why did he go so low the way he did. And when he talked to me on the phone, it was like he was going in and out. And one of the things he said to me was, why did you wait so long to contact me? When he had my number the whole time, he could have contacted me.
Yeah, right. Well, I'm not going to comment on that one. But,
it's funny you're going to laugh at this one, though. My friend, I'm not trying to cut you off, but my friend called him up, and he told my friend, do you know Michelle told me that I need to call the Maury Povich show?
Oh.
I thought you guys laughed at that.
Okay.
I never said anything about that. And he just come out of the blue and says, yeah, she told me I need to call the Maury Povich show. You know the Maury Povich show is nothing about who's my baby's daddy. Are you my baby's daddy?
Yeah. I see two children around Michael, by the way.
There is.
But, sometimes Michael would have been better off if he would listen to his intuition because he had a lot of signs that he was going the wrong way. But he ignored that. So because you said why did he end up like this? And sometimes when we don't listen to our intuition, real bad things happen. But you know, you're like a light at the end of the tunnel, and you're a bright light. So you can help him get back on his feet. But can I be honest with you? I have doubts if he won't make the same mistake again. If he gets tempted, then he can make the same mistake again, even though his intuition will tell him, don't do it. So that's the thing I'm worried about.
Do you feel there's still love there with him? I mean, does he still care about me? I mean, we share a long history. This is my childhood sweetheart.
He does, but at this moment, I mean, the state he's in now, he mostly loves himself more. He does love you. Well, I think if you would meet him, you really need all your strength to be able to conquer his energy and cope with that.
Well, I'm going to try for a meeting in 2011.
Okay.
Maybe he'll meet up with me somewhere. I'm not going to flat out say it. Huh?
He wants to meet you. That's for sure.
But when I was talking to him on the phone, he told me, he goes, you can't be calling me like this. You're going to get me caught up. I mean, she wasn't even around. He's so crazy.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm talking about, that you should be, you know, very strong when you meet him, because you'll need all your strength. And at this moment, you need your strength for yourself and not for him. So put yourself first and then Michael, okay?
Well, God told me in the dream, too, that I'm a miracle child, because I am a miracle child, that I need to start living like it.
Good advice.
I almost died when I was a baby. That's how I have my gift. It's one of the reasons I have such a strong gift. I had leukemia.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you believe in miracles. I'm definitely a miracle child. I shouldn't even be here today. And I need to start living the word of God, which I do. And I used to be very strong with the Lord. But, you know, as you grow older, I never, like, stopped believing in God. But, you know, you go through a stage in your life. And that's what I did. But I'm trying to get close back the way I used to be. But it was very strong how he came to me. But
wow. Beautiful.
Yeah. I feel things on people and I can't explain this. It's I feel energy, emotions, intuition. I feel things on stuff like I almost died this year actually, which I should have followed my intuition. I met this guy, Daytona Beach. Guys, if you're listening, watch it if you ever go to Daytona Beach. I met a guy out there, seemed really good-looking and charming. I just thought I'd share this with you guys because this is a wake-up call. I met him. He seemed really sweet and everything. And when he would touch me, it was like a ghost hit me. I can't explain it. It was like electricity. Like, oh, my God, something scared the crap out of me. Like, the jolt just hit my body. And I got so scared, like, to get away from this guy. And I told my friend about it, and we got away, and he followed me to the bar. And I was ended up drinking that night. And later on that night, they had to call 911. I was in emergency and intensive care. My potassium level shot to a 2.1. If it would have went any lower, it would have killed me. He shot liquid ecstasy into my drink, or it was GHB, one of the two. But my intuition and my guys tried to warn me about it later that evening of that day, and I didn't listen to it. So if you ever have that feeling, trust your instincts because they will never do you wrong.
Yeah.
And that's what happened
very
to me.
Oh.
It was like I seen a ghost. I can't even explain it. You know, like if somebody scares the crap out of you from behind, that feeling I got when he touched me, was it the bad energy that I was feeling?
Yeah. Yeah, a very low energy and totally not compatible with your own energy. So I can imagine you got scared. Yeah.
No, but they were trying to warn me, and I didn't listen to it. And I get that feelings on a lot of things. Like, I'm in a situation, I can feel things on people. I can feel if somebody's with the light, if they're practicing dark magic, shit like that. I can feel that about people.
Yeah,
I can read somebody like a book.
Yeah, I always get nauseous when somebody's doing black things.
So
like,
do I.
Know.
So do I.
Yeah.
And, like, you just get that feeling, like, oh, my God, you don't even want to be in the same room as them.
Yeah.
So I was born with that gift, huh?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. But as for Michael, I really hope that you don't give away all your energy because you're capable of doing that if you love somebody.
Yeah, I feel he's some kind of psychic vampire. I can't explain it. Maybe he is because it's like when I'm around him, he takes all the energy away from me. I'm numb.
Yeah, you can help him, but he has to sort out his own life. But you can help him to a certain extent, and then it's up to him. But if you give him one finger, he wants your whole hand. So that's
a good way to put it. But it was really nice meeting you. Thank you for sharing my story. It was really nice meeting you, Barbara. And, Mike, you take care. God bless you all, and have a blessed New Year.
All right.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. God bless.
Happy New Year. God bless you guys.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Okay, wow, we've got so many calls here. This is less. What do we got left? 9 minutes here remaining. We have another show after this, you all, so Stay with us here. Let's go to area code 917. Are you there?
I am here, Michael. How are you?
Okay, great. We got you on the line this time. Okay. What's your first name?
It's Nicole. I'm calling from Orlando.
Okay. Go ahead, Nicole.
Okay. Well, I'll try and be as quick as I can. First of all, Barbara, I have questions about some of the psychic impressions and information that I've been receiving, and I just wanted some clarification about it. Basically, I've been talking to my guides a lot about things that have been going on in my life, and one of the big things that has jumped out at me the most are my finances. The information they've given me that everything is fine, that there's really nothing that I need to do or focus on, that the money is coming in, it's flowing in, even though I can't see it yet. And I'm having difficulty believing that right now.
Okay. Well, I think it's very nice you talk to your guides. I think everybody should do that. They are showing me a man. He's still alive, and he is going to help you with finances. There's money coming from him to you.
Okay.
And I have no clue. I have no clue who this is. He's still alive. So he's the one who is providing money for you to you. Do you have any idea who this is?
I know a lot of people. There really isn't anyone personally that would sort of jump out at me that I would consider a close friend or things of that nature. But, you know, I guess it, you never know. It comes in many different ways, so.
Yeah. And you know, your guides are right. Your finances are okay. I feel nothing to fear about your finances.
Okay. Thank you. And just another question, too, as well. You know, I've been talking to them a lot about my immediate family. My immediate family is actually across the country, and I'm here in Florida. And essentially, you know, what I've been picking up intuitively and psychically is just that at this point in time, I need to stay where I'm at, and I need to give it some time before I see them in person and before I'm in correspondence with them again. I'm just wondering if maybe that's my own fear or if those impressions that they're giving me are indeed correct and that I need to keep my distance because of the energies that's,
yes,
you know, sort of around them at this time.
Yes, that's true. You will meet up with them, but it's later on in your life. And you also had an almost car accident.
Really? When?
I don't know. But it's already happened, that I can sense, but I don't know how long ago, but you had an angel on your shoulder because it was like a couple of inches and you were be in the hospital.
Wow. I think there was a time where, like, the car, I wasn't paying attention and I was looking the wrong way. And I had to slam on the brakes really, really fast. So maybe that might have been what you're referring to. That could have been it.
It was a close call, and your guides, they helped you with this because it would turn out very bad for you.
Wow.
So that,
okay.
Yeah, nice. That's good. See, guides are always helping us.
Yeah, I had no idea. Thank you. And this is the last question. I am, as I said before, I'm also an intuitive, and I've started becoming more and more aware of my abilities, and my guides have sort of popped into my head to begin to use my gifts and my abilities to give people intuitive readings and intuitive counseling. You know, I myself, I'm still learning. I still have a lot to learn. And I still am learning to trust my intuitive impressions and just the information I'm receiving from my guides and other people's guides. And I just wanted to know if you're picking up on whether or not doing intuitive readings at this time in my life is the best step for me, or if I should wait and gain a bit more experience and a bit more clarity and then do it.
No. what I like about you is that you open your mouth and the information comes out. You're very easy to work with for your guides can, you just have to open your mouth and it comes out naturally. And you go like, did I say that? Was that me?
No.
So it goes naturally. And you were in a building, and this also, this is history. You were in a building and you got sick from that building. And it's so weird because you are so sensitive that you pick up sick buildings. Do you are familiar
yeah.
with sick buildings? And you work there.
Oh, I know exactly what you're talking about. It was a very sick building. Yeah, psychically there was a lot of things going on in that
yes.
place. A lot of people emotionally they were up and down. And for a while I was fine. But then over time, I mean, I could feel myself feeling their emotions and their energy. And ultimately, I left
yeah.
that job. I did end up leaving that job. But do you, are you sensing there's residual stuff still from that? That was years ago, but you're sensing maybe residual things still hanging around that I need to kind of release and let go of?
No. The funny thing is that your guides are telling me things that already happened, and they're showing you that they're saying, look, Nicole, we helped you with an almost car accident. We took you away from the building. They want to tell you that you should have more faith in them, that they are protecting you from harmful things.
Okay.
So.
With that, we got to leave it at that, Barbara, because we're
okay.
about 1 minute remaining. Can you give out your contact information, Barbara, one more time, please?
Yes, my website is barbara-psychicmedium.com.
Okay,
and I enjoyed being here.
Yeah, this was wonderful, wonderful evening. A lot of calls, a lot of people, a lot of deep subjects. So thanks so much, Barbara. We'll see you next week.
Yes, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too, Barbara. All right,
bye-bye.
Okay, everybody, go to the next show. You got to get off the show and click on the next show with Rhea Swift. Okay, when you see that, click on that with Rhea Swift, okay? If you're on the chat only, you're okay. If you're on the phone lines, call back in. Rhea does readings, but she's also a great theta healer. If you need a healing, help, something you need to get rid of, healing in your body. She's one of the best out there. So, second. So we'll be seeing you guys on the other side.